Kerri-Anne Kennerley, when you were saying goodbye to the camp and when you were leaving, you got really emotional. What was that like and why? Why do you think there was that emotion from you?
Emotional because I didn't really want to leave the camp experience. Emotional because of what had happened in the previous hour. And making the decision to go was hard. And, you know, it was a pretty rough previous hour and a half. I can't remember having ever been spoken to like that, oh, that's right, in my entire life.
Well, things did get really intense with Dom, who is who I'm assuming that you're talking about. You know, she said some things, she called you self-centred. What's your take on her?
Dom had two tries at trying to finish the testicles. She couldn't manage it. And that, you know, that's nothing to be ashamed of. She's a vegetarian and it's pretty yucky. She was more disappointed in herself, I believe, and I could tell mentally she just got really, really down on herself. She was disappointed that she couldn't finish it. And I think, you know, worst day of my life and I can't believe I've done this. And so she was imploding way before she got to me.
She accused you of not trying. Do you think that you were up for trying, that you did try?
If Dom had finished that or started and finished that, I would have done it. I could have done it, I would have done it. The boys, they got right into it. If Dom had done it, I would have.
Are you sure?
I would never have let those three down, without question.
Do you think that a bit too much was made about the fact that you were allowed to wear makeup?
I don't think anybody else cared except for Dom, who'd had a bit of a meltdown a couple of days ago.
I can't believe you, my bank.
No, I don't want it. I don't want your Revlon 1989 lipstick, doll. Legit? Nah.
I don't think it bothered anybody else. I don't know. I didn't ask them. It was what it was. I got to take it in because I could, because I asked.
So we had some sticky moments with Dom. Who would you say was your favourite campmate?
Oh, it's hard. I love them all for different reasons. Every single one of them is fabulous. It was so good to spend a bit more personal time with your Pete Hellier. I just don't think there's a better husband and father. I don't think men really get any better than that. As with Woody, magical. And the fabulous Harry the Boxer, a sensitive, searching, wonderful 25-year-old who's got just a beautiful future. Every single one of them is an amazing person.
Why did you want to do this show?
I think a bit of a new adventure, trying to find some mojo that perhaps over the last couple of years I lost. And you just got to reboot, restart your internal self. I think that was a big motivation. Thought it'd be interesting. And who doesn't love South Africa? It's magnificent.
When you were speaking to Sarah before you went into the jungle, you were talking about, you know, trying to find that mojo, trying to find those missing pieces because you're still not sure really quite who you are. Do you think maybe you found a couple of them?
I don't actually go into self-analysis a lot. I just live my life, get through my life, do a bit of work, have a good time. I don't internalise who I am, how I'm feeling at this moment. I just get on with it because I've seen myself go through all sorts of things for the last many, many years. I don't know who other people think I am. And to be quite frank, it's actually not my real concern. People will always make their judgments, and that's out of my hands.
Well, Kerri-Anne, thank you so much for having us be your port of call and taking us through everything that happened to you in the jungle. We'll miss you.
Oh, thank you very much. Ta-ra.